Before a sweeping investigation into the Baltimore City Detention Center, the inmates seemed to be running the place. A deadly gang called the Black Gorilla Family lorded over an empire of drugs and other contraband in the jail, all at the direction of their leader, inmate Tavon White.
Tavon White is wiretapped as part of the investigation, and there's a kind of quote that's really stood out where he said, "This is my jail," something along the lines of, you know, his word is law.
So how was White and his gang able to gain such a stranglehold on the entire system? Largely through seducing its female correctional officers into sexual relationships. According to the government, White even fathered 5 children with 4 different officers, all while behind bars.
The sexual dynamic of the corruption was really important, and what the FBI thinks is that that was a way to establish power over these women, to build these relationships, to really strengthen these bonds. They really had a playbook for how to use sex, essentially, to ensure their dominance.
This is one of those guards, according to the government. Tiffany Linder, seen here 8 months into her pregnancy, got into an argument with another guard, who was also pregnant with White's baby. According to court documents, she said, "Did he tell you we was having a son? Do you know about our baby?" The other pregnant guard responded, "Don't give a f*** about that baby. That's y'all baby, not mine. We having one too. So what?" 2 of the pregnant guards allegedly even got tattoos of Tavon's name.
Up until this scandal broke wide open back in 2013, 75% of the jail's 650 corrections officers were women. And according to one inmate who was a witness for the government, up to 3/4 of those female guards were involved in, quote, contraband smuggling and or having sexual relationships with inmates.
That all began to unravel when the FBI and other law enforcement began to investigate.
They were able to tap the contraband cell phones that the gang members were using to build up a picture of the network, who was connected to who Tavon White had control over, and build their case that way.
The head of Maryland's Corrections Department accepted responsibility when charges were first brought and said people will be held accountable, according to the Washington Post. More than 40 people were charged with racketeering-related charges, including Tavon White. He pleaded guilty to racketeering conspiracy, and this past February was sentenced to 12 years in prison. 24 correctional officers were also found guilty, including Tiffany Linder, and 3 other women who allegedly were impregnated by White. Randy Kay, CNN, New York.